Hello and welcome everybody to the North American Go4GW2 Cup number 41. I am Storm, and with me today is no one, as Heurix seems to have been under the weather the past few days here, so he won't be joining me today. We've got five teams in today's tournament. After the Abjured won the WTS yesterday, they won't be playing today. I believe they're still in Cologne. So this tournament today is kind of up for grabs by anybody. We've got Radioactive in today's tournament. We've got Lookin Like a Cutie, who seems to be a bit of a pug, to be honest, led by Aerox. And then we have Wadioactive, which is the opposite of Radioactive, I'm being told. So we'll have to see how they do against Cutie in the first round. Obviously, these guys are battling it out for 500 USD today, 400 going to first and 100 going to second, as well as gems going to first, second, and third place. So given that, I guess I want to say we might have a little bit of a small surprise for you after the stream. I know you guys are going to enjoy it. I definitely know that. So without further ado, we are going to go into our first matchup, take a look at what we've got for both of these teams today. Of course, no elite specs or revenant is allowed in today's tournament, as that is just beta testing, so that's not going to be allowed in today's tournament. Let's go ahead and take a look what we've got for both of these teams. It looks like I'm having mic issues. Not exactly sure. Hang on just one moment, guys. Let's see if I can get these fixed for you. Perhaps this might fix it. This is a little bit better. We're good. I think we're good. I fixed it. I believe it was coming into my, my webcam. I'm not exactly sure. Hopefully it's fixed. If not, please let me know. I'm not sure why it wouldn't be. Think it's okay. Got some mic static. It's gone. All right, we're good, guys. All right, sorry about that. So our first game is actually going to be Cutie up against Wadioactive. Taking a look at both of these teams. We've got Cutie, they've got Aerox on their team. That's about the only person who's actually on Cutie as far as, the previous Cutie rosters. But the first guy, we've got a couple dinosaurs on this team. I like to call them dinosaurs because they're some of the best players in the game, a while back. But our first dinosaur is going to be Rarnot. Rar played as a warrior, one of the best warriors in the game in the past for good fights. He's going to be playing DDLE today, it looks like, with Selly, Vampirins running Fire, Water, and Arcane. Not the two special. I know I saw him a couple last night, played a few games against him. Looking forward to seeing how he's going to do today because Rar was a very, very good warrior. So excited to see him in today's tournament. Next up, Aerox. He's going to be playing Guardian for this team, running with Rune of the Flame, Legion, and Marauder. He's going to be running Sword Focus, Great Sword, surrounding that Meditation Guardian, running with Virtues, Valor, and Radiance. Next up, Josray, our second dinosaur, running Staff Ellie. Now, Josray is one of the best Staff Ellies, if not the best Staff Ellie in the game, or at least in the past he was. He didn't really play a whole lot with teams, but when he did, they were very, very strong teams. So Josray is someone to look out for. He's very renowned for using Frostbow. So watch for his Frostbow plays because he is a beast with it. He's running with Runes of the Strength, running Earth, Water, and Arcane for himself. Next up, Reku, who played Thief quite a bit in the past. I don't believe he lives in North America, but he does play a very, very solid Thief. He has been on plenty of good teams in the past, so look for him to make some plays today as well. Running DP, Shortbow, Vampirins, Marauder, Amulet, running Deadly Arts, Trickery, and Shadow Arts for himself. And finally, we've got Lighter, who's going to be playing the Mesmer for this team, of course, with the Great Sword, Sword Torch, with Vampirins, Marauder, Amulet, running Chaos, dueling Domination. Chaos over that Inspiration, he's actually not running any Mantras, so really doesn't need it. He's going to be running with Decoy and Portal. It's just kind of a build that we would have seen pre-patch, and then pre the big patch, and then after the Mantra nerf, we really don't see a whole lot of that anymore. But take a look at Wadioactive. Actually has a couple of members of the old Radioactive team. We've got Aerox up first, running the Mesmer with the Great Sword, Sword Torch, as well running the Vampirins, Marauder, Amulet. He's going to be running the same setup as Lighter, nothing too crazy about his build. Tamiya's running DDLE for this team with Holbrook Runes, Water, Arcane, and Fire for himself. He's going to be, looking to dish out a lot of support to his team, as well as some decent damage on top of that. And next up, we've got D'Artagnan, who is Dice, running the sword, or excuse me, the Dagger Warhorn staff with the Strength Runes, running Spite, Curses, and Soul Reaping, the triple Signet Necro that we see on Nos. Next up, Guardian, who is actually going to be playing Ranger today. We don't see a whole lot of Rangers, so excited to see him playing. He's going to be running Longbow with the Greatsword, Scholar Runes, which is going to be, you know, it's kind of like, Scholar Runes is like, it's the rune that you run when you're 100% glass cannon. So he's running Scholar Runes with Zerker, running Marksmanship, Wilderness, Survival, and Beast Mastery. So he's going to be putting out a lot of damage on top of that. And he's running We Heal as one. So he's really going to be lacking that Condi Clear. If he were to take the Healing Spring, he might have a lot more of it. But his only Condi Clear is really going to be Signet of Renewal on top of Empathetic Bond. So we'll have to see how that works out for him. Not a whole lot of Condis coming out for that red team, so he shouldn't be too worried as long as he can stay safe. Finally, we've got Readymade, who's going to be playing the Staff Ellie for this team, similar to that of Josre, except he doesn't take Frostbow, or Icebow, excuse me. He's going to be running Rune of the Monk, and on top of that, Earth, Water, and Arcane, as well as the Glyph of Elementals. So he's not going to be running FGS. Usually when Readymade runs Glyph of Elementals, it is on this map. He will usually run FGS on Full Fire. So, looking forward to seeing these two teams play. Like I said, Rar hasn't played in a very long time on a team. Really excited to see him, as well as Josre and Reku. These guys are, you know, they're renowned players in the past. So, if you're new to the scene, haven't played, or you're coming back after a long break, you might remember these guys from playing on Good Fights and a couple of other teams in the past. But obviously, there is no Abjured today because of the fact they just won the WTS and Cologne yesterday, so they weren't able to make it back to the States that fast. I'm sure they wanted a relaxation day at Gamescom, as I believe today is the last game of Gamescom, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, as I said before, only five teams in today's tournament. Decent showing, at least have a good amount of solid teams. This is actually a semi-final matchup, so the winner of this will be guaranteed at least $100 as a team, because they will be going onto the finals to play the winner between Radioactive and either Soak and Best Team North Africa. So that's another matchup we'll be taking a look after this one. Radioactive against the winner of the 4-5 matchup, the real Radioactive, not the Wadioactive. If Wadioactive goes up against Radioactive, I'm afraid that could be a little bit difficult. It's kind of like Cunning Stunts back when they played, so we'll see how it works out for them. Just waiting on these guys to ready up here, as I believe Guardian is the last one. If I were to take a guess at who's going to win this, despite Reku, Rar, and Josre really not playing a whole lot lately in competitive tournaments, I haven't played in a tournament in a long time, I would still put my money on them, just because of the fact I think Josre is a little bit more potent than Readymade because of that Icebow. Or Frostbow, excuse me. Now I'm going back and forth. Frostbow, he's going to be able to put out a little bit more damage. But Readymade is just as good in the fact that he can sustain himself for quite some time. So I think it's really going to be up to how Reku, Aerox, and Lighter put their damage together. And I think they could put it together a little bit better than Ferox and Guardian because of the fact that, you know, a Ranger's Burst isn't really like as sudden as something like a Mesmer or Thief. So we'll have to see how that works out for him. But taking a look at what we've got for the opening splits as we get game number one underway, guys, in this best of three series. Looks like the red team that would be Wadioactive going to be sending a couple people through that beach. They're just going to stealth up more than likely, while Wadioactive look to just go behind the keep here. They are just going to come up through there. But red team, QD, going to be sending three people over to this henge point. Demise going to be left alone. Josre able to get on point just before he gets that cap. Red team able to get the cap over at the mine point. Demise absolutely obliterated there. Fat Frostbow coming out there from Josre. Going to demolish Demise. Couldn't even do anything about it. Now Rar trying to LOS against the Guardian here. That's a good job, as he's, you know, relying on that longbow to do most of his damage. They're going to give up that midpoint because they absolutely destroyed Demise over at the henge. So they're going to take the sides. Pretty good rotation off of that coming out for the red team, as Readymade making his way over to the mine point here. Able to get the decap. Aerox doesn't use much to get there. I don't believe he had JI to get onto that point. No, he didn't. They're going to 2v1 Readymade here. Ferox going to come plus this fight right here. This is a one cap, as mine was decapped by Readymade, so it is a one cap For both these teams here, no one clearly gaining an advantage over the duration of these fights. It looks like both teams rotating over here to both to the mine point here, trying to make this the big team fight that mid kind of lacked at the start of this game. Now ReadyMade getting pretty low. We see Aerox trying to put this, some damage out there onto it. I believe that's Lighter. No, it's Ferox there. Ferox doing a good job of staying alive. ReadyMade just tanking on this point against Rarnot. We are going to see the Guardian make his way over there. Now Aerox is under a lot of pressure. Get taken in the down state. Guardian comes in here. There's a Time Warp coming out there from Ferox. The stomp comes out onto Aerox, and he is taken out of this fight here. So now the favor of the fight is going to be in favor of Wadioactive, as we do see Dice in a 1v1 against Josre, who left the henge point, going to push over to mid, try and take that Reku pretty low, gets in Shadow Refuge, gets spiked down there. That Mind Stab coming out from Ferox is going to take him out in the Shadow Refuge, still trying to get him up. Lighter in stealth. They are able to get Reku back into this fight here, so that's a good sign that they're still surviving, but it looks like most of them are just going to peace out to the midpoint. Looks like they are. Demise making his way to mid. It doesn't look like Josre was able to do a whole lot against Startanian here. I'll get spiked down by Reku. Pops Plague immediately, about 40%, 30% HP there. Now the mid, I mean, this is going to be the big fight here. D'Artagnan isn't, you know, he's just going to sit on this point for a little bit. The red team not really able to do a lot against them. They're trying to wait. Looks like they really can't get to the Guardian or Demise. They're just getting pew-pewed from afar. Now Aerox, look, Aerox about to be taking down D'Artagnan on top of it. Oh, Aerox able to take down D'Artagnan, going in for that stealth. Will he be able to get it? Evades the fear there. Reku now going in for that stomp, able to get him. That's kind of a misplay. Dice really overextended there. Still, both teams holding onto a one cap over here at the mine. Doesn't look like Red was able to clean up anything, guys. Ferox still in a 2v2 with ReadyMade here, who looks to be getting a little low, has his heal up in just a matter of seconds here. Should be okay for the time being. This fight really isn't going to go anywhere. Good rotation from Aerox. Knowing they killed D'Artagnan, he's coming off of respawn. Aerox comes at the right time, counts that down from 15, knows he's coming off. He's going to take this 1v1. This really favors D'Artagnan, though. I don't think Aerox should be in this 1v1 for too long, unless he's able to make sure, you know, unless Dice makes a lot of mistakes, he should be able to win that 1v1. Now, they were able to take out the Guardian at the midpoint. Looked like Reku just got that stomp. A good interrupt there coming out there from Demise. Demise interrupts the Ice Bow 4 and 5, going to make sure Josre can't use his most potent abilities that really help him in these 1v1s. Now Demise kind of has the advantage, especially with him holding the point. There's no way Josre is going to take this point away from him anytime soon, especially since Josre is getting pretty low there. Now Ferox, the main target over here at the mine. Still, no one's favor. Down about 25 points. Wadioactive, that is. You know, we're 4 minutes into this game, and no team seemingly having the upper hand, but over here at the mine, we did see it looked like Aerox was actually killed there in a 2v1 situation, as the Guardian plus that fight, 2v2, excuse me, Reku wasn't able to help him out, so they're able to get that decap. Probably going to get that full cap. They're not going to let this 1v1 happen. Oh, the Guardian kind of bails out a little too early here. Reku, though, Reku gets knocked back. He is in Vamperins right now. We'll have to see if he's able to stay alive. Gets the Shadow Refuge down, but it wasn't even on top of him. He is going to be taken out. They know he's down there. Blue team taking on that 2 cap over here at the mine, though. Why not? Still in a 1v1. Gonna get help from Aerox off of respawn. They need to clean this fight up now. Like, you know, Red Team had about a 25-point advantage, but they didn't really do anything with it. Now with the 2-cap taking in favor of Wadioactive, they have to win this mine fight. And ReadyMade so good at staying alive in these 1v2 situations. Doesn't have any cooldowns, though, so they should be able to take him out in just a matter of seconds. There he is, finally taken out. But just outside of the mine point, it looks like we see Lighter was actually taken out. Ferox able to take him out, and I believe that was a 1v1 situation. Josre against the knockback. Probably wants to go in for that res onto him. There's the Time Warp coming out there from Ferox. Tries to stomp him, gets the wrong one, gets the stomp regardless of Josre coming in for that stomp there, as he did have that quickness from the Time Warp. Now Josre going to come into this point. Doesn't have a whole lot left except for that Frostbow here. We'll have to see. It is Red Team. Red Team gets that full cap. They really needed that as they are down. You know, oh, the decap from Reku over here at the mine, or the henge point, excuse me. That's going to be huge. They don't want Blue Team to hold on to that 2 cap for too long. ReadyMade, you know, this is kind of a tough matchup for him because Reku is able to evade so much of what he has if he's really careful, and Reku's a very good thief, so we'll have to see how he works out this 1v1 over time. He's going to get help from Lighter, though, who's coming off of respawn all the way through that beach. Stoneheart really going to keep ReadyMade alive for quite some time, not able to crit when he is into that Earth Attunement. But taking a look at what's going on at the midpoint, looks like Josre still in a 1v1 against Ferox now, rather than it looked like that was Demise before. this is, you know, Joe's Ray's really just been in a lot of 1v1s, and it's been on the other team's points, so I think he really needs to get in these team fights. He is still support despite having crossbow, still running earth, water, and arcane, still has double cantrip. You know, he's still got great heals for his team with that Selly amulet, so I think he needs to kind of forget these 1v1s, leave those to, like, Lighter and maybe Rarnot, because he is DD. Rarnot pluses this fight, looks like this is going to be a 2v2 as the Mize gets over here, but blue team able to cap this hinge point over here, and the Time Warp comes out there. I believe that was from Ferox. Yes, nope, that was not from Ferox. That was from Lighter who brought out the Time Warp. Get the deeps down onto the Guardian, and ready made now under a lot of pressure. Probably going to be taken out in just a matter of seconds. Ready made there. He is finally taken out, and they are going to reclaim that point for themselves as they did bring three people over to that hinge point. Now they're down over 100 points. This isn't looking too great for him. Dice trying to help out his team here. I think they should be okay in this fight. They've got three members here against Josre and Rarnot. Rarnot now about to be taken into the down state, running for his life. He jumped there. Actually, I think he read the lightning off of that. I believe it was one of the two. He either jumped, but he died regardless. So that kind of hurt him. That's really going to hurt the team as they, you know, don't have that member at the midpoint. Now blue team really gonna have the advantage, just a couple ticks away from taking the cap. Only Josre is standing on the point. They're able to get an immob or fear him off. Yes, they get the full cap. Blue team taking the two cap. Wadioactive, gonna be holding onto a two cap, but it looks like it was just decapped. No, it was not. It just doesn't show it is. All right, so the bugs are messing with me right there. Okay, there we go. Blue team taking that two cap. And Lighter now bailing out of this. No, we do see the decap actually coming out over at the hinge. It looks like Readymade was able to get that one. Aerox is going to be in a 1v1 against him. Readymade sustained should keep him alive as long as he utilizes, you know, his cooldowns effectively. Aerox probably not going to be able to win this 1v1. We'll have to see how this works out for him. Over here at the mine point, though, Dice is actually taken down. Reku going to get that stomp onto him. That's a good pickup, but despite that, they're still down over 150 points without a cap. It really feels like most of this game, they've just been getting decapped, and it's not even necessarily the best rotations coming off from the blue team. It's just very poor rotations from the red team, as they don't have a thief. They've got Ferox and Readymade, who are really getting the bulk of the decaps here, and it's really hurting them. We haven't even seen a whole lot of great portal plays from Ferox either, and they're still out rotating them. Aerox taking into the downstate. Time Warp coming out there from Ferox. He knows they're trying to go in for that res. Rarnot went in for it and saw that Time Warp. Didn't even want to mess with it. Now he's going in for it with Reku. A little too late, I think. That's going to be a 3v2 situation for them. They really need to get out of here. Lighter going to plus this fight? I don't think it'll be enough, though. We do see Josre sitting over at the mine point. Knowing there's two members at the keep, he can afford to do that, but despite the Aerox was taken out, so this is going to be an even 3v3 over here at the hinge point, or the hinge. We're going to see the guard come over here. We see the portal actually put down there from Lighter, so expect them to go to mid, draw members of this blue team to the midpoint, and then portal back to that hinge point. Reku trying to get the decap. Demise, what are you doing, man? Doesn't see him there for a couple seconds. I'm surprised Reku didn't pop that Bass event and auto-attack him with the short bow to keep him off point. Demise, I think he's still Lightning Flash there, so, you know, it really didn't matter that much. Just below the keep, though, we do see Rock Solid. That would be Rarnot actually taken into the down state here. So much damage coming in for the res from Aerox, but not going to be able to do it against Ferox, Dice, and the Guardian there, so that's not going to work out for him. They're still going to be down a member. Feels like most of this game, this red team has just been down a member at the fights because they keep going into these 1v3, 1v4 situations and overextending, and they lose a member, and then they're just down fights, and the blue team can afford to sit somebody on their home point knowing there's a portal just because of the fact that it's an even fight and they hold the point over here at the mid. So there's really nothing to worry about for this blue team. Holding on to this two cap, only about 40 points away from victory, I think they've got this one in the bag. There's nothing really for them to worry about. Red team probably already thinking about what they want to do in this game number two. I'm very surprised this actually happened on their end. I expected a little bit better of a game, but obviously Josre, Reku, and Rarnot haven't played in a tournament for a long, long time. So kind of a warm-up game for them, I would say. A little unfortunate to get stomped that badly. I expected a much closer game, but Aerox taken down there at the midpoint despite the decap coming out as the blue team wanted to just get off the point, put out the deeps. Getting those kills, giving up the decap is probably a little bit more important, but they're really trying to, I mean, if it really came down to the wire, it would have mattered that decap happened, but not really, because blue team going to be able to hold on to this hinge point. Reku not able to take on a 1v1 against Josre, except against Readymade, especially with the Guardian coming in, putting the deeps down onto Aerox. We're going to have game number one going in favor of Wadioactive, the number three seed in this tournament.
Red team wins a capture point. Just like that, blue team takes a capture point.
All right, so congrats to Wadioactive taking that game number one. Looking very, very dominant in that first match here. Looking to take this against them. It looks like a couple of them were in the wrong team there. Looking to take this and move on into the finals. Again, this is a semifinal matchup. The winner going to be moving on, you know, guaranteeing themselves gems and money, of course. $100 for second, $400 for first place. But there's really, I'm interested to see what this red team's going to do after that, you know, kind of crushing first loss there. Josray, he had some nice 1v1 matchups, but really, he's kind of always strived in 1v1 matchups and obviously hasn't played in a tournament for a while. Didn't really make a whole lot of use of that. I mean, he tried to make use of the Frostbow. Demise really, you know, really interrupted some of his cast, making sure he couldn't do it. Nice updrafts from him, etc. Earthquakes from Demise onto Josray. We saw in one of the 1v1s at the key point. But Josray really didn't have a very much effectiveness in teamfights. I don't think I ever saw him in an actual teamfight. Anyhow, we are just waiting on these guys to ready up and get this game number two underway. Doesn't look like any swaps of builds here. Actually, no, Aerox is going to be moving over to Hammer. Looks like he's going to be running Hammer Scepter Focus rather than the Greatsword we saw last game. Switching to Pack Runes. I think he was Vamp Runes before. We'll have to see how this works out for him. I think the Hammer Burst, you know, this is kind of a little, not really throwback, but, you know, to the last meta. So, ultimately, we'll have to see how this works out for him. I think he's going to be able to put out a little bit more damage just because of the fact it's not as telegraphed as Greatsword Whirling Wrath. You can, you know, get hit by a couple of those Whirling Wrath hits and then dodge roll and, you know, miss, will make them miss most of the rest. But with Mighty Blow, you know, it's one strike, J.I., you know, if you're able to land your Shield of Wrath as well, that's a little bit better, especially if they want to get on top of the Guardian, who actually switched up his... No, he did not. He's still running... Okay, so he didn't switch up his build. So I don't even think the Guardian was the problem. I think rotations as a whole was the biggest problem coming out from this red team. You know, they did win a couple fights. 1v1s really weren't their strong thing. I'm surprised Rarnot has not went to Warrior. I would really like to see him play Warrior. Going back to his roots, we'll have to see how this works out for him on this map. Ready made, still running that Glyph of Elementals. I did mention before he usually runs FGS on this map, so
the match starts.
A little bit surprised to see that Demise has the FGS, so nothing too crazy of changes coming out from either of these teams. We have game number two underway in this best of three series. If we do see Wadioactive taking on this one, they will be moving on into the finals. Looks like Raikou's a little late out of the gate. Shouldn't be too much of a problem for him. We do have Rarnot going to his home point. Three members of Wadioactive going to go to theirs. So they're going to be a 3-point split. Rarnot against Demise. Demise, I think, has a little bit more experience in the DD Elliot matchup. They should be able to take that for themselves if he's, you know, he's able to take that 1v1 there. But the Guardian coming into the point in the low ground, we'll have to see if Raikou's gonna get on top. And looks like Ferox and company getting on top of Josray,
like
who gets absolutely obliterated there, able to get his renewal off, making sure he stays alive, but still took a lot of damage. Ferox pretty low as well. There was a good ice bow or frost bow 4 coming out there from the blue the red team, but it wasn't enough to take anyone out. So now these teams still looking all right. We do have that one cap in favor of Wadioactive still going for them as Demise contests that quarry node for themselves. Now the Guardian under a lot of pressure has nothing. Left, he gets taken into the down state. Raikou going in for that stomp. Will he be able to get it? doesn't get it. The time warp's there. They finally get stomped. The time warp did come out there from Lighter. Ferox didn't throw it down to try and get that res. Now red team able to cap that midpoint, trying to take down Reiku, who's super low. There he is, taking it into the downstate. I think he rotated a little too fast for his team. I'm not so keen on that movement coming out from him. He just, in a 1v2 situation, didn't have any of his team behind him. Now Lighter is forced out of this node, and they're not able to take the advantage of having the numbers there. As the Guardian comes off of respawn, they still hold on to that midpoint. Taking a look at what's going on at the quarry, this 1v1 still looking to be happening. I mean, ReadyMade and the Guardian get a plus. This Aerox coming over here. This is gonna be a 3v1 situation. Will Demise, or will Rona be able to stay alive? Should be okay for the time being, getting some help from Aerox. But now Ferox is gonna plus it. It's gonna be a 4v2 situation. Red team needs to get here as fast as they possibly can. Otherwise, this isn't gonna go too well for them. Four members of this blue team over here at the quarry. Aerox now the main target, being taken down to 50% HP, has no cooldowns left whatsoever, pops the shield wrath, gets taken into the downstate there. We're going to see the stab stomp coming out there from Demise, going to eliminate him from that fight there, as two members of the red team trying to take on a 1v2 situation against D'Artagnan, who has 100% shroud and 100% health. Going to be able to get the decap there. Oh no, D'Artagnan lands the shroud too, able to get onto the point against Reiku, who had Bassy Venomed him, if I'm not mistaken, or at least they had mobbed him there. Not able to make sure he get the, you know, they get the decap. That is detrimental, especially with the decap coming out at the midpoint from the blue team. Now Demise is going to plus this fight. Look, D'Artagnan doing a great job in this 1v2 situation. Finally gets some help. Going to have about 75% HP coming out of that shroud. Reiku sticking on top of him. That cap at the waterfall. Really still ticking for this blue team. Starting to build a very, very small lead. Have to see if they're able to do anything with it, as D'Artagnan now caught in that ring from Aerox. Still looking to be okay for the time being. Actually, no. Doesn't get his Condi clear off. Aerox gets a nice, mighty blow. Going in for that stomp. Just going to banish him off instead. We have the res coming out there. No res actually coming out there from Demise. They did plus this fight. Making a 3v2 situation. Blue team taking the 2-cap on the sides. They're all looking to take mid as well. There's no one for the red team even close. Rarnot trying to make his way here. We'll have to see. No, he's probably not going to get it. He had Lightning Flash. I think he could have got on the point if he really tried hard enough. But still going to get hit there with a nice amount of damage coming out there from the Guardian. Red team able to cap that waterfall node. Is it going to be enough? I don't think so, just because of the fact they're down a decent amount right here, holding on to a 1-cap. Blue team probably just going to snowball a 2-cap for quite some time and build up to 100-150-point lead before they actually make a push for that waterfall node. There's really no reason for them to. Reiku getting on top of Demise, who seems to be in a little bit of trouble. Now it's D'Artagnan who's made focus for them. They could really get on any one of these guys. I think the Guardian, though, look at the damage she's dishing out here. No one for that red team is on top of Ferox or the Guardian. They're all focusing D'Artagnan. And while they're doing that, they're all losing their health. Lighter is about to be taken down. They finally take down D'Artagnan. There was a Frostbite that came out from Jozre. There's a Time Warp going out there. Jozre gets the res on to... Actually, no, the stomp came out onto D'Artagnan. They got the res on to Jozre, Lighter there. Reiku's still pretty low. Gets taken into the downstate. Going in for that res. Nice knockback coming out there from Lighter. Able to make sure he gets back up here. This could be a wipe. We'll have to see what the red team makes of it. We see the Guardian actually piecing out of this mid-fight. Going to go for that decap. Reiku trying to do the same. Being pursued by Demise, though, this is not working out for the red team. They won the mid-fight, but they didn't follow up on it. They didn't even finish people off. They got 2 to 3 kills. I believe they actually got 3 kills at the graveyard. And what came of it? They didn't get a decap mid. They didn't get a decap quarry. And they're about to get full capped on waterfall, all because they won a fight and didn't rotate properly. That is all on rotations right there. And focus target. You know, you get a couple kills, send your thief out to get a decap, come back. As soon as you see somebody else peace out to your home, though, you got to be paying attention to that. And unfortunately for them, the Guardian was on top of it, went and got a full cap on quarry. Now the 3-cap coming out here for this blue team. Wadioactive taking out Aerox as well, looking so strong right here. We still have a 1v1 going on between, 2v1, excuse me, going on between Ferox and Demise. We're going to see Lighter plus his fight. Trying to get on top of it. Looks like, they're just going to peace out of this fight. No, it's a 2v3 situation. Reiku, though, under a lot of pressure, gets Vampirins, throws down SR, but for the second, Shadow steps into the SR, is able to stay alive. So close! Reiku! 300 health, stays alive just barely. I thought we were seeing a forced 2.0 when Reiku actually missed his Shadow Refuge. That was a little bit better of a job from him that time with that Shadow Step, really saving his life as he got knocked out just before he went you know, got into that Shadow Refuge, got knocked down there. Despite that, this 2-cap still come out strong for the blue team. Red team finally able to take that Waterfall node back, but down over 200 points right here. Dice getting so low. D'Artagnan taking into the down state there. Aerox putting out the damage. There's the Banish back to the point. Ferox is actually sitting on Waterfall right now. We'll have to see if he's able to get that decap. I don't believe the red team, you know, they're not going to fall for that. They should be able to see that in time. Still, holding on to this midpoint, Josray won't be dying anytime soon. Or excuse me, Ready Mabe won't be dying anytime soon. With the triple cantrip build, he's able to stay alive. Especially with the Guardian putting out so much damage up top. Reku finally going to get on top of him. It's about the first time all game we've seen somebody for the red team actually try and get up on top of the Guardian, who is running Scholar Runes with Berserker Amulet. You can't let that happen. You can't just sit up there and expect, you know, to win fights if you don't get on top of him. And good job, really, really solid job from Leiter there. Getting on top of him, absolutely obliterating him, but still not able to land that illusionary wave, get the knockback as ReadyMade gets that res onto the Guardian, who's back up to 100% HP with those heals coming out from ReadyMade. Doing a great job of supporting his team, holding on this 2-cap. Now Aerox taking into the down state here. Good rapid fire coming out from the Guardian, who's getting back to his normal habitat up top. Going to be against Leiter once again. Leiter, but he's pretty low right here. Needs to be very careful. Looks like Aerox actually got back up into the fight as Josray got the res there. Take a look at the quarry, though. We do see Demise loses the 1v1 to Rarnot. Really good job coming out there from Rarnot, able to secure that stomp. But still, will they be able to get the cap? It depends if blue team wants to push for this quarry node. It looks like they're not going to. They don't want to risk it. They know they have the waterfall secured, so they don't really care about the quarry, especially with this huge lead. All they need to really do is hold on to this midpoint, and they should have this game under lock for themselves. There is that time warp coming out there. I believe that was from Leiter. Yes, it was a time warp from Leiter. Really didn't make much use of it. Probably just wanted to throw it down, knowing the game was over very soon, see what he could do with it. Didn't get anything done because Vamperun saved his life there. Still under a lot of pressure here. Lord Frenzy going to keep him alive for the time being as Ferox and the Guardian trying to get on top of him. Good maneuvering from Leiter trying to stay alive. Ferox looking to go around the back way, see if he could probably get a decap over at the quarry. We'll have to see what his next move is going to be from himself. Actually, no. I thought he was going to go all the way around the map, but he is actually just going to go back to the midpoint. Wasn't even under a whole lot of pressure. Time Warp coming out there from Ferox. Trying to get the res onto the Guardian as Leiter came in there putting out the deeps, who was just taken into the down state. Nice knockback onto Reku there. Not going to allow for that res on the Leiter. And this game is definitely over, going in favor of Wadioactive. There's no way this is going to be a turned around. This is just complete dominance. More dominance than we had in the first game. We will, however, see looking like a cutie move on into the third place game, who's going to be up against the loser between, I believe, it depends if Soak or Best Team North Africa won. I believe it will be one of those teams, assuming Radioactive can take that matchup in the next semifinal that we will be watching. So there we have it. Radioactive taking that set. Going to be moving on into the grand finals of this tournament. I mean, that was a semifinal matchup. So fortunately for them, they will be moving on into the grand finals to take on the winner between. It will probably be Radioactive. We'll have to see unless an upset happens. I don't think Radioactive has a weird roster today or anything. I believe it's O-Run, Crisis, a little damage. So we'll have to see how that works out for them. We are going to go on a short break, guys. And when we're back, we'll have our next semifinal matchup for you guys. So don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. Welcome back, everybody, to the North American Go4GW2 Cup number 41. We have our next semifinal matchup ready for you guys. It's going to be the real Radioactive up against Best Team North Africa. Best Team North Africa, they're a team that they've played in Academy Gaming tournaments quite a bit, and Radioactive always in ESL tournaments. So seeing, you know, one of the top AG tournament teams up against one of the top ESL tournament teams, we'll have to see how they match up against each other. I don't think we've ever streamed this matchup before, so interested to see how this is going to play out and who's going to be moving on to play Wadioactive. I do believe Heurix will be joining me after this first game, perhaps maybe after the whole set, we'll have to see, but he will be joining me later on for sure, so I won't be solo casting the whole thing. But let's go ahead and take a look at what we've got for both these teams. Actually, North Africa is not up 1-0 there. Let's go ahead and get that change. As Radioactive is over here on the red team, we've got Best Team North Africa over on the blue. Taking a quick look at builds, we've got the big damage running back on his support guard, running with the Mace Focus Staff, with that Soldier Runes with the Cleric Amulet, running Valor, Honor, and Virtues for himself. Formic, that is going to be Ulrun running with the Sword Torch Greatsword with Vamp Rune's Zerker Amulet. He's going to be running Domination, Dueling, and Chaos for himself. Father Jeep, who is actually Tesla, aka Snow Cow, he's going to be running the second support guardian. So they're running two support guardians, running with the Mace Focus Staff. Nothing too special. He's running basically the same thing the big damage was. And they're running two Mesmers. And this is AK running the Greatsword Sword Torch with the Vampirin's Marauder Amulet. He's going to be running Dueling, Domination, and Chaos with the Signet of Humility. And finally, Crisis running the Rampage Warrior with the Greatsword Hammer with that Strength Rune Zerker Amulet, running Strength, Defense, and Discipline for himself. So, double Mesmer, double Support Guardian with a Rampage Warrior. I'm very curious to see how this is going to work out for him. Next, over here on the blue team, we got best team North Africa. This is going to be Wizard of Words running DDLA with Holbeck Runes, running Fire, Water, and Arcane for himself. Honorless Prince, I'm skipping him because I'm assuming he's running the same exact thing that he is. Guys, that he is. Trixie is running the exact same thing, except he's running Earth over the Fire, so he's a little bit more defensive. So they're running triple DD Selly with Holbrecht Runes. Two of them running Fire, Water, and Arcane. And Trixie, aka Random Weird Guy, for those of you who have seen him in Twitch chat, he's running Water, Arcane, and Earth for himself. And they've got double Mesmer, so this is a very odd team comp on both sides. We've got Hisako, we'll go with Hisako. He's going to be running the first one with Greatsword, Sword, Torch with Vampirin's Zerker Amulet, running Dueling, Domination, Chaos. Running with Mass Invisibility, he's also running that Mantra of Distraction, something that the red team's really lacking, so he's going to have a lot of interrupt potential. And Mantra of Pain coming out here for Almighty, who's running the same exact thing for the most part. This is very interesting. He's also running Mantra of Recovery here. So we've got two support guards, two Mesmers, and a Rampage Warrior up against three DDLEs and two Mesmers. I just don't even know what to expect from this game. We've got a Time Warp over here on the blue team with the Mass Invis, while this red team going to be running Mass Invis and Signet of Humility. So no Time Warp coming out here from either of these guys. We'll have to see how it works out for them. And obviously Trixie is going to be the tankiest member of this team, running with Earth over that Fire that we see from both Wizard of Words and Arnoldless Prince. He should be the main one on the points. He's running Stone Heart, so he's not going to be taking a whole lot of crit damage as long as he sticks to that Earth Attunement when he's being the main target or just in the midst of a giant fight. This is just weird. I've never been in a match where it's like three of one class, two of another, and then two other classes on the other team, mainly support guardians, both running with four shouts apiece, basically the exact same build. Tesla, Snow Cow, Father Jeep, all the same person here. He has actually played quite a bit of Guardian in his past competitive days, being on Boreal Esports back December, January, February, around then. So, he's been in a couple ESLs lately. Excited to see him back once again with Radioactive here. The big damage, who has been playing a lot of support lately. Support Guardian, for that matter. Going to be the second Guardian here, obviously. Can't say in recent weeks, AK, who is IUI. That's AK. That's not AK. For some reason, I thought that was AK. That is not AK. Stormed by Pizza. They both have these weird names where they're just random letters with random symbols on top of it. So this is actually Stormed by Pizza. Excuse me. He's going to be the second Mesmer here. I didn't think AK was... I believe that's Stormed by Pizza. I believe so. Yes, it is Stormed by Pizza. Just double checking because their names are either like UIU or IUU or they're weird names. So it's Stormed by Pizza and AK always getting mixed up. I saw the GGWP and I didn't think that was AK. So that's it. No, yes, Stormed by Pizza. I got it. But just waiting on these guys to ready up here. I believe we're waiting on Ulrun. Ulrun always the one that's keeping us waiting here. Now it's Ipno, aka Stormed by Pizza. Now, just looking at this, I mean, more experience is definitely on the side of this red team, don't get me wrong, but I have to say I like the team comp of this blue team better, just because Selly wins. I mean, the WTS proved that. But Mesmer, Double mesmer on both teams. This is just up in the air. If Crisis has some nice rampages, doesn't die to Chieftain or Spawnier in 1v1s, they might be able to take this game. We'll have to see. His recent 1v1s against them haven't went so well. So taking a look at what we've got for opening splits for both these teams, it looks
Best team,
North Africa, going to be having a three-point split. No one for Radioactive, the real Radioactive, going to be going through the beach here. Crisis actually going to see that someone's coming, going to try and take him on, slow him down. He's actually just going to go straight to the midpoint now, as that is where our first big team fight is going to be at. That's going to favor Radioactive as soon as Crisis gets in here.
Blue team,
Father Jeep, really the main target here, coming out for Almighty and company. No one really getting spiked down just yet. Ulrun really not doing a whole lot just yet. They haven't picked the target. Trixie actually going to be the main focus. I think that's the one you don't want to focus because he's running Stoneheart. Now Storm by Pizza Ipno actually getting pretty low here. Doesn't have a whole lot left. Already used his heal. Crisis under a little bit of pressure as well. We'll have to see if he's able to stay alive. Hasn't used Rampage just yet. I'm expecting that very soon. Mantra of Pain coming up. There's the Rampage. Trying to get on Wizard. Wizard going to pop that stab. Should be okay for the time being. Doesn't have Lightning Flash. Crisis really not making a whole lot of that Rampage just yet. Hasn't taken anyone down. Oh, Almighty taking a rock to the face. Oh, was that a 12k crit onto Almighty? That looked brutal. Crisis taking down Almighty. There's the stomp. Trixie was already taken out of this fight. Now Crisis taking into the downstate. And we do see Ipno able to get that decap over there at the hinge point. The res comes out onto Crisis there. Taking a look over here at the mine. The cap not in anyone's favor. So we've got decap nodes all around here. As we have the Elementalist Wizard going to be piecing out from that midpoint with the FGS over here to the mine point. And the Radioactive claiming that keep for themselves. Looking to send Ipno and Crisis over there. Maybe they're debating what they want to do next. Looks like the main target here seems to be the big damage. Oren really not taking a whole lot of damage here. There's so much support coming out from the big damage or
just
potential
like that,
of it that
blue team takes
probably not the greatest target. We'll have to see. Oren just going to stealth up here and try and get behind Almighty. Coming out from that midpoint, making his way to the mine point, knowing that 2v2 is probably not going to go in their favor. Now Crisis putting out the deeps. Doesn't have any cooldowns left. Just popped his last one that would be Endure Pain. Doesn't have a Rampage up for another 60 seconds. He's getting pretty low here. A lot of damage coming out there from Seiko. On to Crisis. Crisis still pretty low. Now Ulrun. Ulrun getting taken down into Vampirance here. He is super low in stealth still. He should be okay for the time being able to get this heal off. Now Crisis under a lot of pressure. And the big damage. This fight's really looking to go in favor of this blue team. All of them 100% HP. The big damage taken into the downstate. Arnolus Prince doesn't have stab. Not going to go for the stomp. We do see the cleave. Oh man, the cleave for this best team, North Africa. They are going to take sides, reclaim this mind point from themselves, for themselves, excuse me, as Ulrun still running for his life. Almighty knows he's in the area. Will he be able to take him out? He's about 50% HP. Lands that mind stab.
Like
won't be enough, though.
Blue team takes a
he's
going
to actually get hit out here by Seiko. We'll have to see. Seiko just kind of running around. Ulrun just all over the place. We're going to see Crisis coming off a respawn to that beach to take on the 1v1 against Trixie. Have to see if Crisis is able to take him out. Trixie is, of course, the one with that stone heart, so he should be able to stay alive longer than any other of these elementalists in this game right now. As we see Ipno actually taken down over here by Svanir. Looks like Almighty and company were able to take him out. Ulrun coming in, putting out the deeps on Almighty. Almighty getting pretty low, taking in the Vampirance. So is Seiko. They're both trying to kill Ipno as Ulrun goes in for the res. Will be enough. Ulrun now under a lot of pressure. Almighty has 300 health, able to get his mantra off there. Should be okay. Ulrun just going to go for the decap over here at the mine point. Meanwhile, over at the hinge, we do see Crisis and the big damage in a 2v2. They love this fight because the brothers... these two are brothers, obviously, Crisis and the Big Damage. They love taking on 2v2s together because they practice them all the time. And Trixie now under a lot of pressure here. Should be okay for the time being. Crisis, does he have Rampage? Has Rampage up? Already used Rampage at this fight, actually. Wasn't able to eliminate anyone. Blue team taking the Spawnier there and taking back Mine. They're still holding onto that one cap with a decent lead here, about 40 points in their favor. Still looking to take this 2v2. We are going to see Ipno come from that midpoint. Going to try and plus it. Good damage coming out onto Crisis. They're not able to land a whole lot of 100 blades. Double DD Ellie matchup, though. You know, I think they've got a lot in their favor here as long as they don't get plussed, and they are because Ipno come. Actually, They are not. This actually went back to the midpoint. Not going to plus that as red team actually gets the cap over there. Able to take out both elementalists. That is a really good pickup for this red team. They're all at 100% HP right now. All they need to do is hold on to this two cap, start to build a lead with it. I would not be surprised if they didn't push for that third node. Looks like I had a bit of static coming back there. Sorry about that, guys. Almighty able to stealth up here. Have to see if Oren's able to take him out, gets a nice amount of damage onto him. Ooh, portal's out of there. It's a very, very short portal. Nonetheless, going to survive. Get a couple ticks of that mantra off. Mantra of Resolve. So he should be okay. This blue team is kind of all over the place right now. Take a look at their Mesmers. I mean, we got one here. Now, Oren's just trying to spike these members down. They've got Anonymous Prince sitting over there at the mine point. The rest of them finally regrouping over here at the Henge. Trying to get on top of the big damage. Big damage obviously going to be the main target for him. Seeing as he's the only one here for the time being. Get some help from Crisis. Should be able to maintain himself for a little bit longer. Has no cooldowns left. Will he be able to stay alive? That Shield of Wrath going to keep him up. Not for much longer there. Wizard of Words now under a lot of pressure. Does get this top just in the nick of time. But Crisis with that Whirling Blade going to be able to take down Wizard and Almighty. Doesn't use all of the 100 blades. Crisis has Rampage up in about 5 seconds, but obviously doesn't need it. Honorless Prince going into the midpoint thinking about it. Hiseko still in this fight as both members of his team over here. I mean, they took down the big damage at the very last second, got that stop, and then Crisis just obliterated him and took them out of the fight, deleted them from the map. I'd be surprised right now if Crisis bailed from this, knowing there are respawns. There's really no reason for him to leave this point. Where else is this blue team going to go? As long as they have the big damage kind of patrolling that beach node, or, you know, checking where people are at, they already have the mine. All they could do is go up straight up through the mid where Father Jeep is actually sitting around. There we see Formic can be taken down quite low here. Has his heal. Going to get a little bit of help coming out back from the big damage. Probably able to put out a few heals to him, but the decap comes out regardless as he did have to stealth up. The big damage was not on the point just in time. Almighty now with the rest of his team. Looks like the main target is going to be Crisis. Crisis is going to pop the Rampage here. Let's see who he's on. He's on Honor's Prince, who has stab, but that's not going to be enough for him. Crisis actually CC, despite having stab stacks, gets the kill on to Honorless as Orun now able to cleave him down. There's no way he's getting up. Red team do get the two cap once again as they do manage to cap that. Crisis still put out the... Look at the rest coming out onto this blue team member. Oh, man. That was a fantastic res coming out there from Hiseko and company. Able to get Almighty back up into the fight. And now trying to take down Oron. Still, the game is definitely favor Radioactive, but I did not expect something this close right here. Now Almighty a little bit out of position. Has a little bit of help from Wizarding, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. Force to blink out of here. Use Massive Viz. Oren knows he's in the area. There's Oren's Massive Viz. Probably going to spike him down immediately after Almighty comes out of stealth. They don't know that each other are there. Oh, Oren doesn't see him. So he's going to take on that 1v1. Back over on this point, we saw Seiko was actually taken out. Now the main target is still Crisis. Crisis has Frenzy left. That's about it. There he pops it. Trying to put out the deeps onto these elementalists. Not going to be enough for the time. Bing, we'll see. Oren plus this fight. Crisis probably going to be taken down in a matter of seconds. Actually, Adur Pain coming up there from his trade is going to save him. As these two DDLAs are trying to stay alive. Over here at the midpoint, taking a look, we see Almighty and Tesla in that 1v1. Almighty just drops the portal, going to bail out of this fight. Honorless Prince actually taken out over here by Crisis and company. There's the Quickness Stomp coming out there from the big damage from that elite skill. That elite shout going to get him that quick stomp. And now they're going to force the rest of this blue team out of this node. I think it's in the blue team's best interest right now to get Wizard to that mine point. All come off a respawn. They just got spawnier. Only down about 75 points right here. Make a big push somewhere. Portal in there. They have a portal on the mid node. Hiseko actually getting rest here by Wizarding. I have to see. There is that quickness coming out there from Father Jeep. Able to get that quickness res from that shout. Really good use of that. He really hasn't been doing a whole lot. Crisis actually taking down the 1v1 against Chieftain. They get the kill. Crisis was actually taken down in that 1v1 against Chieftain. Honorless Prince comes and tries to take it. Crisis' down state abilities get the kill and take Chieftain for themselves. So, you know, Crisis a little lucky there, but regardless, they do kill Crisis. Looking to get back to this Henge point, but the game 50 points away for Radioactive. Now the burst coming out onto Seiko as his heal. Needs some help from the rest of his teammates. Just a little late to the party, coming out after getting that kill onto Crisis. They were messing around, I believe that was with Oren there. Actually, no, that was Ipno they were messing around with. Ipno is IUI, for those of you that are just tuning in here. getting pressure down a little bit, but all red team needs to do is hold on to these 2 points. No one for the blue team even contesting mid. I think they have this in the bag. I don't think best team North Africa going to be able to get back into this game. Yeah, only about 10 points away. We'll have to see what this blue team decides to do in the next matchup. There's not a whole lot. You know, they did a great job this game. I did not expect them to put 354 points up against Radioactive, best team North Africa, who is, you know, they're a top team in the Academy Gaming tournaments, for sure. And coming out into the ESL, which is always what you want from these lower tier tournaments, to see these teams come into ESL and see how they do. 354 onto Radioactive. You have to give them props. Great job to them, but Radioactive definitely coming out on top in that matchup there. So I don't believe Heurix is actually going to be joining me just yet. He might join me for the final series. We'll have to see. But hopefully, I'm hoping he is here, as always. Nice to have a co-commentator with me for those things that I do miss, as I do only have two eyes, obviously. But, I think that was a very, very good game. Really great rotations from this blue team. That's really what kept them in the game. But the team fights really went in favor of this red team. And Crisis, I'd have to say Crisis was really, you know, an MVP of that game. Him and the big damage. I mean, Crisis was, he eliminated people just like within seconds because of nice whirling, his greatsword whirl. And his rampages were spot on, you know, despite going down to Chieftain. You know, that happens to Crisis every once in a while. So, you know, but still did a great job in team fights eliminating those Ellies. That was probably the biggest worry, knowing they had three Ellies on their team. One was Stoneheart. Really good job from Crisis and company on eliminating them in that first game. But, you know, you got to give props to this blue team. They did a great job coming up against, you know, arguably, you can't argue, Radioactive is one of the top teams in ESL. They finished top two past several weeks. Maybe not every single one of them, but, you know, they're in the midst of the top three, top four ESL teams every single week. So, you know, really good job, the best team North Africa. We'll have to see on Legacy here if they're going to be able to keep it up and, you know, give them a run for their money. Anyhow, just waiting on these guys to go ahead and ready up. I believe one of the blue team might be changing classes, bringing something a little bit more, you know, meta, team comp-wise. We'll just have to see. As again, guys, I do want to point out, we do have a little bit of an announcement coming out at the end of this stream. So, you know, definitely stick around for the end. Don't just peace out. I know you guys are going to, I know you guys will like it for sure. So stick around for that if you guys are interested in that. But it looks like we do have Trixie back. They're not going to be switching up the comp. Perhaps he just DC'd from sitting there for a little bit. Doesn't look like there's any changes as a whole coming out from the rest of these Ellies here. Let's take a look at the Mesmers. No, Mantra Pain still going in favor of Almighty there. You know, I believe the Seiko actually had Mantra of Distraction. There's the Mantra of Distraction, yeah. So we'll have to see if he does take the portal or if he's just noticed that the stream's on him right now. They don't have portal, not really able to make a whole lot of use of their mobility that a portal would obviously allow. Ulrun and Ferox, Ulrun. Ferox is on Wadioactive. Ulrun and Ipno, excuse me, guys, soon. Both have that portal for themselves, so. Okay, we do have game number two underway. If we do have Radioactive take this, it will be moving on into the finals. And, you know, the loser of this series obviously going to take on looking like a cutie in the third place matchup, which we usually do not see. Take a look at the opening splits for both these teams. Radioactive going to be sending Ulrun to that far point. Looks like they're going to be doing a 3-point split here. Ulrun going to take a 1v1 on against the DD Ellie. Have to see how that works out for him over here at the quarry, though. It looks like Crisis and Father Jeep going to be in a 2v3 situation. Crisis absolutely obliterated there by Seiko and Almighty. Gets portal. That was a great portal coming out there from the, you know, I believe that was Ipno. Great portal there. Getting the Crisis out of the danger and back to that midpoint. Now, ooh! Ipno actually spiked down a little bit by Hiseko, who managed to land one of his mantra hits there. Doesn't fully kill him. There's the time warp onto the point, I believe, that just came out there from this red team. No, that was not. That was from the blue team. We saw Almighty bring out that time warp. Hiseko taken into the down state is Crisis. Dud Pop Rampage has no cooldowns left aside from Dirt Pain. But still, despite that, we see the one team fight in favor over there on the quarry of the red team. Crisis coming in, putting out the deeps. Red team claiming that quarry despite being down just a little bit. We'll have to see if Wizard is able to stay alive for at least a little bit longer. Crisis on top of him. He has Trixie for support. Trixie, obviously, the tankiest member of the team running that Stoneheart. Looks like Ulrun gonna be in a 1v1 over here at the waterfall. Sees Almighty. Oh, the burst, only about 50% HP. Doesn't take him down too low. Now Crisis getting targeted over here by the red team, blue team, excuse me. Doesn't have any cooldowns left. Has, oh, the dirt pain, but that poison, the bird stack's gonna take Crisis into the down state. Ulrun coming in for the res. Will it be enough? Ulrun gets the res along with, I believe that was Ipno there. Now Wizard under a lot of pressure. He's gonna be taken in down state in just a matter of seconds unless he gets some heals and nice support. There he's taken down by Ulrun and Ipno. Ipno bringing that Blurred Frenzy. There's the 100 Blades coming out there onto Almighty from Crisis, seeing what we saw in the last game. Absolutely obliterating two members of this best team, North Africa. Now Crisis under a little bit of pressure. We do have heals coming out there from the big damage. Probably gonna be able to keep out alive, Crisis alive. Despite that, blue team still holding on to this node. Hiseko, the only member kind of standing here. Trixie is kind of low. Should be able to get back onto the point before Hiseko has to use his distortion. There he's going to use it. Hiseko is so low right here in terms of what he can defend himself with against Crisis. But that damage coming out onto Crisis, going to take him down pretty low. The big damage, still about 100% HP. Crisis actually, oh, will it be enough? Taking into the downstate, Trixie tries for the updraft. There is the time warp coming out there from Hiseko. I don't think it's going to be enough. Will it? Trixie taking into the downstate. Going for the stop. He gets the stop onto Crisis. Gets the res onto Trixie. Now, oh, the big damage is forced out of this fight. That was a huge play coming out there from Best Team North Africa, who ended up losing that first team fight. Now, the big damage is under a lot of pressure. We see Ulrun coming in trying to support him. The big damage taken into the downstate. Gets the res as Ulrun had stealthed him up there. That is a huge play coming out there from this red team as they get him back up. Ulrun probably going to get that decap over there. Meanwhile, over here at the core, we see the 1v1 between Ipno and Almighty. Both these guys about 10% HP. Almighty gets his heal off. Here comes the heal from Ipno. Will it be enough to keep him alive? We'll have to see. As Crisis is going to plus this off respawn. Almighty needs to be careful. He's going to be taken in downstate unless there's Vampiroons popping. Does he have any cooldowns left? We'll have to see. He has Blink. Will it be enough? He's going to get out of there. His Wizarding Word's going to come, support him. Tesla on the move as well. They're trying to make sure they don't give up this cap. They don't want to. They have about a 25-point lead here. They are a couple ticks away from getting this decap. Or the full cap, excuse me, in favor of this red team. Father Jeep, not going to be able to put out a whole lot of damage. Of course, there's Almighty taken out there by Crisis, absolutely obliterating him. Look, 12.3k like finishing touch from that 100 blade there. Blue team claiming that waterfall once again over here at the midpoint. We do see Ipno trying to get red on top of Honorless Prince. Point. Should be able to stay alive for a little bit. There's a little bit of a skirmish up between the points, so as we see the portal come out there from Ulrun. Good portal play from him. Trixie probably not going to be able to make it there in time. Doesn't have Lightning Flash, so no, he will not. There's the decap. His red team claims that quarry. No, we're going to see Tesla kind of sit there on his Prince, though. Under so much pressure. There's the Rampage from Crisis. Is he able to get alive? Get away alive, excuse me. Yes, it looks like so. Now Wizard going to be the main focus. Oh, gets hit there. It looked like mid-burning Speedy got hit. Man, these auto attacks in the Rampage are just deadly. Not from Crisis. There's the Time Warp from Hiseko. Excuse me, that was the time warp for Almighty as they decided to take double time warp. Last game they had one of them on time warp and one mass and viz. Double time warp coming out from these guys. Radioactive back into this game, going to be taking the lead right there. As Tesla still sitting at the quarry, taking a look over here at the waterfall, we see Ipno actually under a little bit of pressure. The full cap on the waterfall should be going in favor of this blue team. Just a matter of seconds. There's the portal. Like Ipno going to put it down, make them have to watch that point. Over on mid, we do see Crisis actually taken into the downstate by Honorless Prince and Almighty. The res comes out there from the big damage. Get Crisis back up into this fight. He is probably just going to run out of there. Looks like my mic is having more issues. Sorry about this, guys. Unfortunately, I'm not sure what is going on with it. But red team, Radioactive, just a couple ticks away from getting this full cap. Actually, one tick away from getting this full cap at the midpoint. the big damage. Ooh, gets hit by a lot of that, you know, the burning speed there and that ring of fire. He's getting taken down pretty low. Has only one shot left. Take a look at what's going on at the waterfall. We have to look at this burst flood that's going to be coming out from Ulrun. Gets Almighty down to about 50% HP here, who doesn't have a whole lot except for that Mantra of Pain left. Oh, that decap from Ulrun. Could it be enough? Doesn't get the decap. And we're going to see Wizard plus this fight take on the 2v1. These guys are all tied up. We do see the gate is actually down, I do want to point out, for Radioactive in case they ever want to go for that portal play on the Lord, which I'm assuming we can anticipate later on in this game. As they do have two portals. It'd be really, really cool to see, like, a portal into another portal. Like, you know, they have double portal. That'd be cool to see, but doubt that's going to happen. Crisis actually went down, got the res there, as we did see that time warp come out there from the blue team. Didn't actually do anything with it, as Crisis did get res. Now Father Jeep under a little bit of pressure. Looks like Ulrun thought that was one of the mesmers here. The health pools definitely favor the blue team. Still a tied up 161 to 161 guys. 4v4 at the midpoint. Whoever takes this fight is going to start to take the lead here. Ipno under a little bit of pressure. Able to get a seal off. Yes, he does. Portals back to the waterfall where Wizard is just sitting there. I mean, I'm not one to really like when people sit at their home nodes, but if the other team's doing it, I guess you can, especially with portals. He knew there was a portal there. Crisis goes down. The stomp in favor of Arnolus. Prince gets the stomp on the Crisis there. This could be game-changing there. Now have that five-point lead. Ulrun gonna go up to the steps here. The big damage isn't actually sitting on the point. I'm not exactly sure what he's doing. He actually swapped places with Tesla, who's back at this midpoint now. Only a couple ticks away from this getting the cap on the mid. They can't allow this blue red team to get the cap. That is gonna kill them later on. So this is just huge. I mean, this game is so close right now. We do see Ipno is actually super low here. Six stacks of burn. Oh, 1,000 health. Gets his heal off. Should be okay for the time being. Crisis back into this fight with the Rampage. Pops it immediately. This could be game-changing if he's able to pick up a kill. Trixie, though. Oh, man. Lightning Flash is out. No, he doesn't. He has Lightning Flash. I'm surprised he hasn't used it yet. There is the Time Warp coming out there from Hiseko. That was Almighty's Time Warp. They're going to get the res onto Trixie. Christ is not able to do a whole lot of damage when that Time Warp is out, obviously. Hiseko has his up, for those of you that didn't see, in about 90 seconds here, so they could use that later on in this fight. But this fight is just so back and forth. Crisis is about to be taken into dust. No cooldowns left. We do see, oh, Crisis putting out the deeps, but about to die himself. So much damage coming out from this blue team onto him. They do manage to take out Trixie. We do see Wizard not really going in for the res. They don't think that's going to happen. There is that mist in the down state. There's the Lightning Flash. Wizard knows this fight is probably lost, especially since Trixie just got taken out. So did Honorless Prince, who's going to try to get back onto the midpoint. The two cap coming out there for Radioactive. This is where we're going to see Radioactive start to take a lead. Radioactive have a very strong hold on their 2 points right here, and they're not going to let up on the pressure. It looks like they're going to try and force them back to the waterfall node. Getting on top of, you know, Hiseko, they can't, blue team cannot afford to lose a member right here, because then it's going to be staggered respawns, and they can't afford to let Ulrun get this decap. Ipno gets this decap. If Ipno gets this, that is going to kill them. There's a Lightning Flash FDS for Trixie, saving the day over on the waterfall. But now we're going to be able to see about a 50-point lead for Radioactive after this game being so close all game long. No one having a clear advantage. Hiseko, they're going to clean up a fight here. They're going to take out a member of Radioactive and make a big push through that mid and get a decap soon. That last fight lasted at least 5 minutes. It seemed like it lasted at least 5 minutes here, and that's why this game was so close. Now they're trying to get down Ipno, and if they're able to hold them off, there's the portal. Could this happen? If they get this decap, this is gonna be massive. There's the decap. Ipno with the plays over at the waterfall. That was an excellent portal. Now we see Crisis going for the Lord. Daz Rampage up in 20 seconds. He's just gonna sit down and wait for the Lord. Oh boy, Crisis. Oh boy. Wait for Rampage, rather. Sorry about that. Just sitting just in his like that, in their respawn. Now, if somebody of this blue team dies, they're gonna know Crisis is there. Crisis goes in for it now. Has a Rampage up in about 5 seconds. Will it be enough? Crisis died to Chieftain last game, so I'd be surprised if he didn't die to the Lord. There's the Rampage. 50% HP on this Lord. 40% interrupts the heal. That's gonna be it. They're gonna be taking him out, and they're gonna be winning this game 2-0. Taking out best team North Africa. Crisis with the solo on the Lord there. Good game, well played to both teams. You know, you gotta hand it to best team North Africa. I mean, we've seen them in a couple ESLs. We haven't actually casted them, but they did a great job against one of the best teams in the ESL Cup. So you gotta give it to them. Congrats, you know, to them to making it this far. They're going to be moving on to play looking like a cutie in that third place matchup. That should be a great game, to be honest. But we will have Radioactive moving on into the finals to take on their counterpart, Wadioactive. This kind of reminds us of the Abjured and the Absurd back in December. So excited to see this matchup because members of Wadioactive used to be on Radioactive. That's going to be a fun matchup, guys. But don't go anywhere. We're going to want a short break. When I'm back, hopefully I'll have Heurix. So stay tuned, guys. Welcome back, everybody, to the North American Go4GW2 Cup number 41. I am finally joined by the magnificent Heurix, who, you know, he missed the first two sets, but he's finally with me for the most important one that is going to be the finals. How are you doing today, Heurix?
Ooh, could be better, but we're back in it. We're ready to go. Excited for the finals match, man.
Yeah, definitely. I'm glad to have you here for this finals because, you know, it's usually the Abjured, but they're not in it today, obviously. So it's Radioactive up against Wadioactive, who, as I said before when you weren't here, Wadioactive actually has members on their team who have subbed or been on Radioactive. Namely, you know, Ready-Made, Ferox, Guard, Demise is subbed for him. I'm pretty sure Dart has too. So all five of them, if I'm not mistaken, have been on that Radioactive roster. So excited to see what they're both going to be bringing to the table today. Let's go ahead and actually take a look at what we've got for our first for these guys. It is going to be Radioactive. That would be DK over here on the red. And someone had the brilliant idea of making Wadioactive BK, backwards D. So we'll see how confusing that is. Go ahead and take us away with the Radioactive team, though.
All right, we're going to start off here with Auron here form the Mesmer here. He's going to be off on Sword, Torch, and Greatsword with Rune of Vampires and Berserker Amulet. Playing a pretty standard Mesmer build here today with Domination, Dueling, and Chaos as his setup here with that portal, of course. Next up, we do have the big damage. He's going to be opting for that support Guardian as usual here with Mace Focus and Staff, Rune of the Soldier, and Cleric Amulet here. He's going to be taking Valor, Honor, and Virtues, of course, for that support setup. Crisis probably going to be taking up that Berserker build. We saw that last matchup there with Hammer and Greatsword, Rune of the Strength, and Berserker Amulet here with Strength, Defense, and Discipline. Obviously, be mindful of that Rampage that brings out a ton of damage with this setup, and especially with that that double Cleric Guard that they've been known to run here, at least today, can keep that guy out for quite some time. Next up, we do have another Mesmer running Greatsword, Sword, Torch, with Rune of the Vampirism and Marauder Amulet this time around, as opposed to that Berserker. Running Dueling, Domination, and Chaos, of course, as well. And finally here, we do also have Father Jeep here with Mace, Focus, Staff, Rune of the Soldier, and Cleric Amulet going to be taking up Honor, Valor, and Virtues as well.
Yeah, so the double support guard, double Mesmer, and Crisis. And I don't know if you saw the last matchup, but Crisis was doing so much damage, even outside of Rampage, really eliminating the triple Ellie comp that we saw in the last matchup. So look for him to be making plays here as well as the Mesmers. Taking a look over here at Wadioactive, aka BK. We got Demise running DDL with Selly, running with Holbrook Runes, Fire, Arcane, and Water. Nothing special about him. D'Artagnan, the Necro for this team, running triple Signet Selly Necro with the Dagger Warhorn Staff. You know, fairly standard stuff. Ready Made, as always, playing that Staff Ellie with Earth, Water, and Arcane, running with Rune of the Monk. And Selly Amulet, he's going to be running that Glyph of Elementals once again that we saw in the last matchup. Ferox is going to be playing the Mesmer for this team with the Sword Torch with that Great Sword. He actually just left. We'll take a look at his build when he's back here. The Guardian, though, playing the Ranger for this team with the Scholar Rune. Zerker Amulet running with Great Sword, Longbow, with Marksmanship, Wilderness Survival, and Beast Mastery at the bottom there. And Ferox is taking a look at what he has here. He's running Vamp Runes, Marauder Amulet, running Domination, Dueling, and Chaos with that Signet of Humility. So this is exactly what we saw the first time we casted, or the first match that I casted today from this blue team. So they're all sticking to what they had before. I think this is going to be a very, very fun match.
Yeah, I have to agree. It's definitely something to look forward to. And if anything, just the interesting factor of the fact that it's Radioactive versus Wadioactive, it's going to be kind of annoying to cast, to be honest, but definitely looking forward to it. It's going to be an exciting match, first one of the day, but definitely looking forward to the finals for sure.
Yeah, definitely. So I think, like I said, I guarantee every single one of these guys has played on a team together, all 10 of them, and some ESL at some point, because I do know that all five of these guys have been on Radioactive, maybe not D'Artagnan, but have at least subbed or been on Radioactive at some point over the ESLs, and that's just That's something you don't see very often. And Radioactive against Wadioactive. Yeah, that is going to be a little bit annoying. I might just call him like DK and Wadio to make it a little bit easier. But just waiting on these guys to ready up. Taking a look at them. I know you didn't see the other matches. Give me a quick prediction on these two.
I'm going to have to give it to the OG Radioactive. Just, you know, they have a pretty strong setup, I think. If they can't shut down, if this blue team can't shut down Crisis, they're going to be in a world of trouble. That, like you said, has so much damage potential. And I think they're going to do well with it. So it'll be interesting to see. They still have that double Mesmer as well. They still have a lot of mobility on the map to move Crisis around as they wish. So I'm going to go with red team for this one.
Yeah, take a look at the opening splits. Ready made. Is going to push for that far node. He is going to pop the stab early and lightning flash to get on top of that point. Gets a little bit of nice damage out there with that FGS. Going to be in a 1v1. Actually, 1v2 is Ulrun. Nope, this is going to be a 1v1. We've got Staff Ellie against support guards. So that's going to go on forever. What else do we got going on around
just
the map
like
here?
That.
You know, this is going to be a pretty big fight happening over here on this keep node where we already see Demise taking a lot of pressure. He's downstated already here, already sitting there. No one in sight, really. He's going to get stomped out there by Father Jeep, and looks like Father Jeep's going to go ahead and get that full cap as Crisis moves off, kind of hovering around, just making sure everything's good. If you look over at the mine point, though, Ready Made versus Big Damage here, that's going to be a stalemated fight for quite a long time. Ready Made's doing a pretty good job already, but Big Damage is going to be able to sustain that for quite some time as, of course, Ready Made doesn't have too much damage pressure. Dice and Crisis, however, moving in. And with Crisis right next to Big Damage, that's going to be a lot of damage and a lot of...
Oh, there's a Rampage.
There. Like Rampage. Yep. He's going to come out.
He's going to be on Ready Made. Ready Made, oh, already down to about 10% HP. Uses that Lightning Flash. Not going to get too far with it. Crisis going to change focus onto Dice here, who takes about 50% of his HP, just a couple of hits. Now he's getting CC'd out of there. Doesn't have any stabs left, so he is going to be out of that Rampage. Doesn't manage to take anyone down, but forces a lot of cooldowns to be popped there and a lot of damage coming out there from Crisis. Now, he is very low and has no cooldowns left. Look at the bleeds taken on him from Dice. I suspect he's going to be taken down in a matter of seconds here. Look at the Condies.
Yeah, Dice did a really fantastic job, actually, of maintaining his health pool and also just going to Death Shroud to try kind of absorb a couple of those hits there when he didn't really have anything left. He got a couple of bleed stacks onto Crisis, which, of course, since he only has Berserker Stance, once they're on, it's pretty hard to get them off. Looks like Big Damage is going to be able to get him right up, and it does look like that's going to be the case. He's going to be back up and into the fray. Crisis is going to be...
That was a 3v2. That was a 3v2. Ferox and Dice weren't able to put out enough damage. Readymade, obviously, I mean, we could have seen Dice going for that Plague Stomp. I'm very surprised he didn't. Now Ferox trying to put out the damage onto the Big Damage. He was going to be taken into the downstate there. They tried to go for that Plague Stomp, but it didn't actually work. Now Ferox taken into the downstate. Crisis putting out the deeps. Will it be enough? Reds
looks
goes down
like
onto the big damage.
Big damage back up. Because of that Frenzy taking down Ferox there, they might actually turn this into a kill as well. Ferox is going to get stomped out there by the big damage. You saw the big super stomp animation there. It looks like red team is going to take this fight as blue team ready made as well as, who is that, I believe?
The Guardian.
That's the Guardian there going out, and it looks like they're going to try to take the fight over towards the keep where Ulrun's kind of already sitting there waiting to demise is in the area as well. Guardian takes a little bit of a hit. Doesn't have any cooldowns, actually, if you look at it. 3 seconds left on his heal as well as 3 seconds left on Signet Stone here. It looks like he's just going to kind of wait a lot of this out. Other than that, doesn't really have a whole lot.
Did you see that?
Like this fight
Red
is going
team
to be,
got
a
capture point.
We just saw Portal. Portal from Ulrun. He's going to be right over here at the hinge. Will Dice be able to get there in time? I don't think so. Oh, just in the nick of time, Radioactive get that decap. So they're going to be holding on to a 2-cap. Taking a look at the midpoint, though, really not in favor of the blue team. Crisis actually getting pretty low right here. Needs to be careful. He has so many Condies. Hasn't popped Berserker Stance. He's going to get Portal out of that fight. Good Portal there. I believe that came out from Ipno at the midpoint. Now they're trying to take out. Looks like Readymade was the main target. The Guardian is now the main target. I mean, the Radioactive have full HP bars right now, but they're really not getting anything done as Radioactive starts to build a pretty decent lead with that 2-cap.
Yeah, as soon as anyone gets really low, I mean, that double support guardian, they want to get them right back up. I mean, Father Jeep is about to go into downstate pretty shortly here if he can't get some support. And he does actually get some support. Still has shelter that he can use. He's going to be up pretty close to full health there. And they just have so much of an ability to just kind of stay in there. And they only really need Crisis to do most of the damage here. Mesmer can kind of cycle in and provide some burst as well. And they do so very handedly. Already made almost taken out. Almost immediately there, but is able to get off point with that lightning flash, get the Aether Renewal back up. But
and Demise, yeah. And there was a Rampage from Crisis. There's the stomp coming out there from Ipno on to Demise. So they're not going to be able to do a whole lot at this midpoint anymore. We see Ipno actually bailing out to get the decap over the hinge. No one for the blue team even close. Oron still barely holding on to this mine. There's the decap. Dice able to make sure he gets off the point, at least stealths up to get out of there. The big damage is going to get in here, but still, we're going to see a decap over the hinge. One tick, you know, favoring Radioactive right here. Starting to build up to 100-point lead. They're looking pretty strong.
Yeah, they are indeed. Looks like the next fight is going to be moving over towards the mine point where Crisis is already putting a ton of pressure down onto Dice. Dice accepting most of it in stride, though. Looks like they're going to try to turn it back on him, but Endure Pain is back up as well, so Crisis right now going to be taking a lot of pressure. Looks like we're going to see a lot of pressure actually being dropped on the Dice, who does
just
get to
like
steal off both the Signet of the Lincoln and the Signet of Vampirism. So he's about 30%, but doesn't have anything left anymore now. Crisis,
but look at Crisis, is so low.
Defy,
I mean, he
does come up.
Oh man, the Dice actually taking it. Dice, look at the frenzy 100 blade coming out there from Crisis. Able to destroy Dice, no chance whatsoever of getting that res. There was the stomp from the big damage, gonna force the rest of this blue team out of there. Nice portal coming out there from, I believe that was Ferox, gonna port three of them to the midpoint. Demise actually got through the portal. Oh, Ferox tries to res him, accidentally hits portal and gets ported back and doesn't get back through. That is detrimental to them winning this midfight.
Red team got
yeah,
a capture
absolutely.
Point.
I mean, for sure. I mean, he's going to have to be walking all the way back. Lost a lot of precious time there. Going to have a lot of back pressure from Crisis as well as he followed him there. Looks like already doesn't have a lot of his cooldown, so he's at about 30% health. He's going to be dropping pretty soon if Crisis can follow up a lot of that heat that he put on at first. Looks like he's going to cycle in, and there's no one even near except for people in red. Like, there's no way
the blue team's just all
right
over the place right now. Look at it. We got a couple of members actually going to take on the big damage over here at the mine. It's going to be a 2v1. We've got the Guardian and Dice against the big damage. You know, Oren's going to plus this fight. The big damage should be able to stay alive. He's still got shelter. He's got plenty to keep himself alive for Ulrun to get here, make this a 2v2 fight. There's Ulrun going to plus it. So is Crisis. Crisis has Rampage in 2 seconds. He's probably going to pop this immediately. I would not doubt. He's going to hold on to it for a little bit, see if he doesn't have to use it. But he usually does in these situations. Now they have over 100-point lead. There's the Rampage getting on top of Dice. Dice is going to be taken down here.
I'm sure Dice is pretty upset with this pressure being brought on by Crisis. Crisis jumping on his body, actually. But it seems like every time Dice comes out, tries to get something going on the mine, Crisis all over him, especially with that Rampage. But even without, just so much pressure being brought on him. I mean, that constant pressure of Greatsword Hammer is just absolutely insane. Hard to come back from that. But looking at the keep right here, we're actually seeing Guardian ready-made on the point. Looks like we got both Mesmers and Father Jeep as well. We actually saw a portal come out. They're going back over to the mine.
Oh, the MOA.
Big damage in the MOA. Downstated already, so great rotation from them. They're going to be able to turn this point blue here.
That's about the only chance they had to get back into this game. I mean, a real legit chance, and they took advantage of it. That was a great portal. Now they're going to put out the pressure at midpoint. They're going to cap. They take the 2-cap. They're not out of this game yet. Especially Demise taking into the downstate there. That's not really going to help here. Ferox going in for the res. Will it be enough? Crisis has so much damage. Oh, the stomp going to try, but able to get a backup in this fight. Now Crisis is the main target. You know, this is blue team's best opportunity this game to get back into it. And the Guardian get taken down there. Oh, Crisis absolutely obliterating him. You know, blue team really need to take advantage of the 2-cap, maybe get a boss kill, and they really can't afford to have too many deaths out of the nodes here.
Yeah, they really can't. I mean, right now they do have a pretty good lead right now, 360 to 224 here, but I mean, with this fight moving over to Hinge, we're going to be seeing Crisis add to it. We're going to be seeing Ulrun add to it. I would have to say that I see Red Team probably pulling away with this fight coming out. Ferox not in really a good position at the moment to really get anything done here. He doesn't have a lot of his shatter cooldowns. He might be able to get a burst here onto this Mesmer from the Red Team here. IUI is going to be able to potentially open him up. Looks
he
like
doesn't
that.
Even
it's
land
not
it.
The case. Misses that.
He was on top of that rock. I think Ferox should have got on top of it. He just thought it would land, but it didn't. Nothing hit there. So that was really unfortunate for Ferox.
Should have definitely had the foresight to see that. I mean, a lot of players should know by now that those.
But Crisis was stomped.
Can't teleport to him. So.
Crisis was stomped right there, and you said it might go in favor of the red team. Well, blue team's they're holding on strong. Just you know, two ticks away from being decapped. There's a MOA onto the big damage. There was actually a MOA onto
and the
Dice. Excuse
onto
me.
Big damage as well. And the CC coming out from this blue team is absolutely insane. Bringing down big damage there, and it looks like the Mesmers are the only ones kind of keeping this fight alive here. It looks like they're going to be going.
Oh, go for that
res! And it might actually happen with the Symbol going down.
Oh, man.
So he's back up. The Guardian, pretty low here, was able to get his heal off, so he's back up a little bit, but not looking good for him as he drops even lower here. There's a lot of pressure on this point. I mean, you even have to watch out for the staff, please, being, you know, something like 800, 900 DPS coming out from that staff cleave. Have to look out for that because of the power difference that came out. Dice in the down state, Guardian in the down state on the point. Ready made in
this
the
is
down
a,
state off on
oh line. Man, this
is
terrible.
Just a complete turnaround as Crisis comes back out of spawn and rampages ready made right
oh,
on down.
Oh man.
So
that
they
is...
do actually come out. It looks like I was indeed right.
You were right. You were right. I have to hand it to you. That's just really unfortunate because blue team, that was their chance to get back into the game. With losing both of those fights, like you said, Crisis coming off a respawn. You know, that was a very valid use of Rampage to just get rid of ReadyMade, get that decap. And now they're looking to take this game easily now. With its two cap, blue team really, I don't foresee any chance whatsoever of them getting back into this game. They're all up, all 100% HP, all around the map, all three nodes right here. They're looking so strong to take this game number one.
Yeah, Demise right now at about 20% HP. Looks like he's going to be trying to take a lap real quick as well, trying to get some health back up from that Signet heal. He's extremely low as he accepts a huge rush crit there, still at about 20%. Crisis looks to take him down, Dice in the arena as well, but Father Chief just keeping both of them alive for the most part. But Crisis now taking a lot of pressure here at about 30%, dropping quickly. Does still have Demise, but other than that, nothing.
Lands the
Demise is downstate.
That Earthshaker onto Demise crushed him there. But look at Crisis about to be taken out. Will Dice be able to finish him off? I'm not so sure. Crisis does get some heals there, coming out there from Tesla, aka Father Chief.
Absolutely insane here.
There's a GGB called for ReadyMade. We're going to have game number one being in favor of the original Radioactive here. You know, that was a very, very dominant early game from Radioactive. Kind of faltered mid-game. And then those two fights on the side notes really just solidified the victory.
Red team wins a capture
and,
point.
We're actually going to be seeing that solidify the game right there. Dice being taken out. 504 to 308 first game. So... I kind of expect to see the same thing in the second game coming up. You know, they have a pretty strong setup right now. They're playing pretty well at the moment in comparison. I'm not really seeing a whole lot come out from Ferox. I think we saw like maybe two portals, and one of them was actually accidental where he went back and really messed up there. Had to kind of spend about 15 seconds walking back. Got absolutely decimated by Crisis in the meantime and was forced to miss out on that fight there. So... had a couple of slip-ups there for sure. Dice being just absolutely pressured completely out of most of those team fights by Crisis, especially with that Rampage form there. So I expect to see kind of the same thing happening in this game, unless I really don't see them changing a whole lot to kind of answer that. The Guardian right now hasn't been able to do a whole lot onto Crisis as you might expect him to be able to accomplish. I mean, kind of stay out of those fights, but for the most part, he's been kind of on the point a lot more than I would expect him to be.
Yeah,
which
definitely
obviously
so.
He's been taking a lot more cleave than he probably should. I mean, the last couple of games in the team fights, he was actually killed by the Guardian, by the support Guardians just staff cleaving because, I mean, he's just sitting on the point, that's accepting a little bit too much pressure, not being off. But on this map, obviously, it's a lot more open than Forest, so he might be able to get a little bit more going here. He's taking, you know, Protect Me as well as Signet of Stone. So
I mean, he did have Sikkim. He did have Sikkim, but he's taking Quickening Zephyr now. I'm surprised, you know, he's played a fair amount of Warrior. I'm very surprised he hasn't made that swap. But I think they like that range pressure onto Ipno and Ulrun, so we'll have to see. That Forest is obviously, like, the worst map out of all four competitive maps to have a Power Ranger on, right? So Legacy is one of the best. So we'll have to see if he's able to, you know, take advantage of that terrain that, you know, he can really abuse as a Power Ranger. We are just waiting on these guys to ready up and get into the second game. Looking forward to seeing how what changes this blue team that would be Wadioactive make. I'm expecting a 3-point push from them. I mean, Demise or ReadyMade will push for that far point, take on a 1v1. ReadyMade did it in the last game. I wouldn't be surprised to see it being Demise this time. DDLE has a little bit more damage than that staff, Selly. Silly staff with the monk runes that ReadyMade is running. So ReadyMade actually usually takes FGS on this map, but we saw it in the last set of that we saw him playing in this set as well. He's going to be taking Glyph of Elementals once again because, you know, he's got Demise for the FGS. They don't really need it. That Glyph going to be able to help him, you know, whatever attunement he decides to use it in, whether that be, you know, I really feel that water is one of the best as well as air. Nice stuns, nice heals for the team. So we'll have to see how that works out for him. That's really going to help him in his 1v1 matchup. So he might go far. We'll have to see. Just waiting on these guys to ready up. What are your predict? I mean, you did say you're thinking Radioactive once again. What do you think the blue team needs to do right out of the gates here to try and make a better opening for themselves?
Oh, they really need to focus down Crisis here. I mean, they have the ability to. There's no reason why they shouldn't be able to. I mean, Ferox alone should be able to bring him down and force the Defy Pain out very early. Force probably most, if not all, of the big damage support there, as well as Father Jeep if he's in the area as well. But if they can't focus down Crisis, if they can't get him down, and they should be able to, he doesn't have a big effective health pool, so if they can't do that, then they're going to be eating way too much damage in this fight. I mean, we've been seeing 7, 8, 9k arcing slices, huge whirlings, just no pressure being brought out to him, and because of that, he's been able to really do a lot of work.
Yeah, and there's
see how they answer it.
There's that three-point play coming out from both these guys. I expected Ulrun, in the first set we saw, they did the same thing. He went for the 1v1. He's going to be a 1v1 against Dice, but over at the quarry, that's going to be a huge fight. What's going on over here, Heurix?
Over at the quarry, we're actually seeing Ferox in the area, so technically this is a decentest matchup, Guardian in the area as well, so a lot of range pressure to be brought down onto Crisis, but so
just
far
like
nothing's
that.
Really been done. He's at about 100% HP. Did see a portal come out from, I believe, Ferox there, and it looks like he is actually still in the area, so he opted just to kind of see if he could get someone over, but
Crisis.
No one answered that call.
Crisis
and
with the rampage!
That will be it for Ferox.
Yeah, it will.
2% HP.
And look at Demise, too. Demise is super low. One more throw rock could take him out. Oh, he evades it. Demise with the moves. Going to mitigate a lot of damage he could potentially have taken from Crisis. There's the cap
red
on the quarry coming out there for the red team. The blue team, you know, they're just piecing out the long way. We do see,
just
looks
like
Ferox is kind of sitting here.
Point.
He's just, I thought he had maybe DC'd or something. But at the midpoint, we see Demise actually taken down. Guard finally gets back into this fight. Demise back up into this one. There's the, he had just missed it. Readymade actually taken down as well. Radioactive looking so strong right here at the mid fight.
Yeah, this is already looking pretty strong for this red team. Crisis taking a little bit of pressure, although, and looks like that's going to be answered rather quickly. Dice in plague form. It looks like that little bit of pressure being dropped down from Ferox here. Ferox still not really able to land a whole lot of shatter pressure onto Crisis, which, as we can see right now, as soon as you put a little bit of pressure on Crisis, he just drops really, really quickly here. That Defy Pain already did come out, so he's at 80 health, 115 health, gets dropped, big damage, going for the res. Everyone on red team actually going for the res.
That was
there.
Nice. That was a very good res. Now we see Ulrun going to go for that decap over at the waterfall. They know they're okay for the time being. No one for the red blue team actually pursuing them. Crisis is still pretty low right here, but doesn't need to be too worried because the big damage. He's going to be able to easily get that res, I think. Nope, there's the stomp coming out from the guard. Oh, he stops the stomp. There's the stomp coming out from Readymade. Good communication to get that stomp off. Just try and get that extra bit of cleave. Now it's going to be the big damage in a 1v3 situation as Ulrun did manage to get the decap over at the waterfall, but mid, still hasn't been capped as the big damage is taken out. This is still anyone's game to take right here.
Yeah, I mean, comp-wise, I really do feel like the team should probably be able to take this, especially on this map here. I mean, they have the pressure to take out Crisis here, and then as soon as Crisis is down, they just have free reign to just take out both of these Guardians for basically free. And we can see it on the screen right now where big damage is just getting absolutely obliterated. They aren't putting enough damage, it seems, to actually bring him down, but they have the ability to definitely put him on the back foot there. So many Condies on top of him, so much power damage can be brought dropped as well. Looks like Ulrun is forced out of the fight a little bit here, forced to Massive Biz as well. Doesn't have Atherfeast for about 15 more seconds because he just used it here. Looks like he's going to be looking for a target, but I mean,
yeah.
Oh, we actually saw a portal come out.
Yeah, we saw a portal.
Ulrun going for that.
That 1v1.
Ferox actually did see that, so he's going to counter portal there and get over to that waterfall node for that 1v1. They didn't manage to get anything out of it. Looks like Ulrun might stick around to see what he can do in a 1v2 here as
well. Yeah,
Dice, a plus one as well.
Yeah, and I'm not very surprised to see that because Readymade and the big damage is going to be in that 1v1. Demise is going to plus this fight over at the waterfall. I mean, both teams holding that one cap here. Mid is only a couple ticks away for the red team to get it. They can't, a blue team really can't afford to give up this mid point because we've seen how tanky and how much sustain this red team can really have despite, you know, having the double Mesmer. Over here, Crisis, though, super low. Did just get out of Rampage. Probably going to be taken down there by Guardian. Father Jeep going in for the res. Will it be enough? Neither of them going in for the stomp. They're just trying to cleave it up. Father Jeep not going to let them get that kill there. So good res coming out there from Tesla as the decap comes out here. Despite the res, they did give up the decap. So the blue team going to start to, you know, build their first lead of the game. Looks like the Guardian still trying to stick on top of Crisis, using that terrain to his advantage. Stops that barrage just after he cast it. That's a little bit of a waste of cooldown, but that Moa onto Crisis, gonna make sure he didn't do anything about this. I'm not so sure he's gonna be able to stay alive. That Defy Pain is what is saving him right there. He would have died without Defy Pain. Man, you were right. That has just kind of been the MVP of Crisis right now. There he is, finally taking it in down state. Knockback coming out there from the res. Will it be enough? No, it is. They do not get the stomp. Good res coming out there from the rest of the red team.
Yeah, that Guardian there just being able to just quickly bring him back up. I mean, it's pretty ridiculous, especially if they can get some stealth play onto it as well. Looks like we do see on the graveyard still a 1v1 between Big Damage and Dice, which obviously is going to stalemate for quite some time. Dice does have a favorable opposition there, though, in that matchup, so he might be able to do something with it. But in the meantime, Ready Bait at about 25% HP. Used a lot of his cooldowns actually just now to try to get back up to 100% HP, so they might be able to turn a counterburst onto him pretty shortly. But we're actually seeing a lot of damage already being dropped onto Ulrun, who's at about 25%. Does have his heal up. Looks like he's going to be going for a portal play to bring everybody over towards the midpoint, where Big Damage actually might not be ready for it. Crisis, in the meantime, though, just waiting for that portal, does accept it. Looks like Ulrun was able to get that out early enough, and they're going to be able to maybe bring down Dice extremely quickly here. It looks like Crisis is going to go for that back cap, though, over onto the waterfall, where there's actually no portal ready to go for him at all so far. So he's going to be able to free cap this, probably.
Yeah, but blue team take that quarry. So despite Crisis able to get that decap there, and Dice really not paying the greatest of attention there, it was kind of under a little bit of pressure, though, from one of the mesmers. You know, it didn't really hurt them, but mid was actually capped by Radioactive. There's Crisis with the Rampage. Dice saw it coming. He had, you know, about 75% Shroud show. So Crisis has to dig through two health pools to take out Dice. Probably not the greatest target, to, you know, because of that. And Crisis is going to get condied up here. Ulrun came in for the burst as well to take down Dice. Now, if they're able to coordinate it like that, like they just did with that 17k final strike from the 100 Blades, man, that is brutal. Now Ferox under a lot of pressure. He is going to get out of there with that blink just barely. As we see Radioactive probably going to mop up this fight. Demise going to be in a 1v2 situation. We'll have to see how long he can hold off.
Yeah, not sure how long that's going to be at all. We're actually going to be seeing Red Team potentially come back here. Crisis putting a ton of damage down onto that portal, where it is still 3v2 actually. It looks like with Dice, Demise, and Ferox trying to follow up Crisis.
Well, Crisis is just going for the gate right now. He's ignoring the fight completely. He wants to do what he did in the last set and just solo Lord. We'll have to see if he does that or if they go for the portal play.
Yeah, I mean, especially with Rampage, I mean, he can pretty much just waltz in there and under any sort of pressure, just put everything down on top of that Lord and just absolutely obliterate it. We actually saw Ferox getting taken down without the help of Crisis there. Looks like he was able to come in, though, and he's already putting a ton of heat down at the Dice, who's at about 10% HP and dropping quickly. The world does take him out, and there's the Frenzy 100 Blades doing 17k damage right on top of that downstate. So quickly taking Dice right out of the fight here. So two down from this blue team. Red team already coming back into it right now to catch it up very, very quickly. Moa on Demise, where it looks like that might be enough to take him out too if they can get some more pressure down. But he's doing a great job of kiting around, making sure that he stays alive for at least a little bit.
Yeah, and it looks like Demise, you know, he has FGS, has stab if he needs it. Should be okay for a little bit longer. He is, he's had a lot of experience on DDL. He's a very solid player, so he's holding off pretty well. But he's going to be taken off, you know, down in just a matter of seconds. Unless, I mean, he's got Stoneheart, obviously. I think that's a switch from last game. I don't think he ran Earth Attunement. So they're going to take him out of that fight. The guard is in the area, but we'll have to see if he's able to take down Ulrun as Dice comes into the fight as well. Man, they're really putting a lot of resources over at this waterfall. It's a decap node, so that's a really good move from Radioactive. They don't want to fight at the midpoint. They're never going to take that away. There's the portal back to mid. So as I say that, they actually portal back to mid to try and take it. I really think that was a poor play. I think they should have stuck on waterfall. Because now it's going to be 2-cap in favor of Radioactive, and they're not fighting on a decap node. Crisis coming in with the Rampage onto the Guardian. We pop Signet Stone. There's the portal. Where's it going to lead to? It looks like to the Lord.
Big damage, though, taken down in the meantime. Looks like ReadyMade is going for the stab stomp. Is not able to get it. I mean, the quickness on the res was just absolutely insane. Able to get him back up. Resistance on that as well. So he's able to quickly get back up and into the fight. He's at 100% of HP again. So everybody on this red team looking very, very healthy right now. And in the meantime, Dice taking a lot of pressure forced over to the quarry. It looks like We're going to be seeing one follow-up from the Mesmer on this red team here, and that's probably going to be enough to maybe take him
decap.
Out. Just one burst,
oh, gets the decap! Ferox, nice illusionary wave there. Gets the decap. Oran not able to get on that point in time. Now they just, I mean, they're only down, up 4 points right here. They need to fight on this waterfall. No, this is anybody's game. This is a little bit different from last game when it was just more, it's basically domination from Radioactive most of that game. Now it's just back and forth here. Crisis lands a nice Earthshaker onto Ferox here. Will he be able to stay alive? Ferox is kind of running for his life. Crisis still pursuing him. Doesn't have Rampage up for another minute and 20 seconds here. There's the decap over at the quarry, mitigating all income from this blue team right here.
Yeah, it's 265 to 264 right now. So, I mean, they're going to be able to finally take the lead here. Red team looks like all run, though, might be brought down here. But looks like that decoy at 25% as well as the Vampirians are going to be able to save him for the meantime. He did put down that portal just now, so be careful of attention to that, Crisis. Almost got stomped out there. Almost.
Ready, May, going in for it. Oh, wow.
That is going to be it. So he is stomped out. Blue team might be able to turn this fight back around as everybody from the red team is kind of forced off the node, not looking very healthy for them. We still do have Ulrun with that portal there, so I think they should just leave this, move the fight over towards the graveyard where Big Damage is kind of sitting there waiting to do something. We actually saw the portal come out already.
It was just back up top, though, so it's not. It didn't go very far.
Yeah,
if this cap goes in favor of the red of the blue team, man, I mean, you know, if it stays this close, I want to say Radioactive has it because of the fact they've got the gate down. We saw what Crisis did in the last game. Expect the same thing to happen, or at least a portal play for it, and there's really nothing the blue team could be able to, you know, do about it. With the double Mesmer Crisis, I don't think there's anything they could do about it.
Yeah, not at all. We're actually seeing it swing back in favor of the blue team after that fight that they just won here. So still a very, very close game. Ferox being taken down to about 10% HP. Not looking so good for him. Does have the Vamp Runes, though. Is able to get his heal off, so he's at about
10%. Look at Crisis. He's making a move, and the Guardian saw it coming.
Yeah, is the Guardian going to have enough, though? It looks like the Endure Pain already has to come out from Crisis here. He's probably going to be popping the rest of his stances and going in for the Rampage. And that is going to be the case. He's putting a lot of heat down onto the Blue Lord. He still does have Defy Pain, so he has at least 5 seconds to take out the Blue Lord, which I do think is enough time for him to be able to accomplish that task.
Oh my gosh, will it be enough?
It is going to be enough.
No! Ready Made with the heals! Takes down Crisis! Ready Made, the MVP of that!
The weakness for sure.
Wow.
Also saved that for sure. I mean, that was prevented so much damage from coming out. Ready Made able to make that play. So with that, I honestly think that blue team might be able to turn this around here. They still
what
do have a couple
save.
Points lead. Crisis out. They're going to be able to go in onto the waterfall node where actually Demise is taking a little bit of pressure. If he can sustain for a little bit longer, at least long enough for Ready Made to get over and get some heals, if they can raise it back up, then blue team might be able to turn this back around. He does managed to get that Vapor Form. Looks like he's going to accept that portal there as well and perhaps get a full res, but it does not look like that's going to be the case as Crisis actually is still in the area here. He's going to be coming back up, and he's looking for a Guardian. He's looking for a sweet, sweet revenge.
No, he's
here.
Going back to it. He's going back to the Lord. No, is he? Is he? He's debating it. Okay, no. Oh, now they're going.
Like
now they're Olin's
going to follow him up here.
Yeah, no Rampage, remember. No Rampage here, so we got two members of this Radioactive team. They're going all out here. They don't even need to. But look over on the other side of the map. We've got Dice going for the Lord by himself. Crisis popping the Frenzy Hunter Blades. Misses like 95% of it because the Lord actually ran past him.
Yeah, and he's in a lot of trouble here. Defy Pain already forced to come out. Big damage is in the area, so he might be able to get some heals at least, but not a whole lot of damage being brought down on the Lord already. It looks like they were able to get Guardian into the downstate here. So it looks like they're going to try to res. He's trying to get some CC out as well, but Ferox not looking healthy.
Crisis.
Ferox at about 10%. Crisis being taken down. Looks like that res is actually going to manage to happen. Ferox was trying for the res. Crisis does come back up, and the Lord dies in the meantime here. So that's going to be 531 to 382. Red team taking it. The real Radioactive is your victor this week.
Yeah, and on the other side of the map, I panned to it at the last second there. We actually saw Dice had died the 1v1 to the Lord. He kind of was like a last second effort, you know, attempting to get it. But Radioactive going to be taking that 2-0, crowned your weekly number 41 champions. Now, that's something we don't hear a lot because obviously the Abjured take every single one of them, but they're not
something
in it this week.
Never actually heard.
Yeah, we don't actually ever hear it unless the Abjured just isn't there. So, any last thoughts on that match there, Heurix?
Definitely a fun match. Interesting to see Radioactive go up against Radioactive, seeing as how a lot of those guys have played together. But congratulations to Crisis and Big Damage. I mean, they've been fighting, I think, what is it, 30, 40 weeks now, trying to get a top spot. And with Jared out, they're able to finally get it here. Looking forward to next week to see if they can defend their title.
Yeah.
Coming back against an Abjured that just won the World Tournament Series. It's going to be pretty rough, in my opinion. But...
Yeah, well, you got to keep in mind, the seedings are based on the previous week's performance. So, does that mean Radioactive gets the number one seed? We'll have to see.
We will have to see. Abjured finally not in a red side.
Yeah, they might be on blue.
Jokes about that.
Well, they were on blue a couple times in WTS. I don't think that was a huge matter for that. But I do want to go ahead and say a few things, guys. As always, if you guys have social media, you can follow ESL on Facebook at facebook.com/ESLGW2. That's right below me, as well as on Twitter at ESLGW2. Follow myself and Heurix. I am at StormGW2 and Heurix and the rest of the DPS crew over at Digital Pro Sports. And of course, I did promise you guys a little bit of an announcement. Both Heurix and I will see you this Wednesday from Burbank, California for the ESL Monthly. It'll be both of us casting the ESLs hopefully from now on. So looking forward to that. Looking forward to casting with Heurix in person. I think that's going to be a damn good time. What are your thoughts on that, Heurix?
Yeah, definitely looking forward to it, man, for sure. It's going to be a really fun day for sure.
Yeah, definitely. So that is it from us here today, guys. We will see you this Wednesday. You got something else?
Yeah, I do want to say congratulations. We got a couple of guys in the chat here. I just want to say congratulations from the NA side to the Abjured for taking the World Tournament Series. We talked about it a little bit before, but I just want to say congratulations from us to you guys for taking that. That was definitely a really fun and entertaining match. I enjoyed it a lot watching you guys go through that. So congratulations to you guys. And looking forward to seeing everybody on Wednesday for that monthly with the both of us.
Yeah, definitely. So I'm really excited about it. It'll be a good time. But that is it from us, guys. Apparently the third place match wasn't played yet. So hopefully we'll get that updated after that has been done on the ESL website. But hope to see you guys Wednesday at 7 o'clock Eastern. I think it's 4 o'clock Pacific. We'll see you then on the Guild Wars 2 stream. Have a good night. See ya.